next speaker is going to be Public Information Officer Tony Wooten, and he's going to talk to us a little more about how a little one-on-one self-defense.
All right, I usually do the part he just did, so you have to get involved. Most of my career, I've been out talking to people and telling how people do different things like this that you've heard earlier today. So it's a little bit of a challenge for me because that was kind of my passion that I've been doing for years. Jeff mentioned Neighborhood Watch. I have created Neighborhood Watch. He mentioned Chesapeake. Chesapeake was one that I was a part of. I did the Neighborhood Watch for Chesapeake. Neighborhood Watch is a tricky thing. I'm going to tell you why. We've got some good neighborhoods here that the neighbors know each other well and they like each other. It works real well. I'll go into a little quick story real quick. A few years ago, if you remember, there was a Georgia Tech student that lived in Dawson County that was on the terror list, and they ended up taking him down. Well, they lived in Dawson County. And the subdivision that they lived in, I taught Neighborhood Watch to. I formed Neighborhood Watch in the subdivisions, half in Pike and half in Dawson. I felt real proud of this, and I didn't get the accolade that I wanted. But the FBI had actually went into that neighborhood and did surveillance several times. And because of the Neighborhood Watch, so this is a good plug for this, Neighborhood Watch, because it was so good, we kept having neighbors go out and say, who are you and why are you here? You don't belong in our neighborhood. So the FBI had a hard time. Now, I asked the sheriff, I said, can I get accommodation from the FBI or something? Because I did a really good Neighborhood Watch program. The FBI can't do surveillance. I feel pretty proud of the fact that we already have them. Neighborhood Watch is tough, though. It's tougher than it sounds with a lot of issues we've got. A lot of times, if you look at Dawson County, you see there's a lot of people who live here that work other places. They're not real known to their neighborhoods. They don't really know their neighbors real well. So you kind of got to be careful because of the other side of that. I got a call, and if you're familiar with this, there's a place called Moss Estates in our county. It's never been an area that's been a great place. There's some good people that live in there. Unfortunately, there's some bad people that are in and out of there. There's some transit people. A lady called me, just moved in there, and she said, I want to start a Neighborhood Watch program. I said, where do you live? And she said, Moss Estates. I said, you do realize that you'll be telling the criminals next door, hey, I'll be gone this weekend. If you see anything you like, just tell yourself. So it only works when you have people that care about each other. And that, not that that can't happen. We got great communities in Dawson County, great subdivisions that can do this kind of stuff. It is a challenge. We've had a lot of people talk about it. Some subdivisions wouldn't do it because they just couldn't get the number of people together that wanted to do it. So it is a challenge. It's an ever-evolving thing going on with our community, being that people move around. Real quickly for me, I am Tony Wooten. I'm running for sheriff in Dawson County. I've been your public information officer. I've run the jail, I've run the courthouse, warrants, patrol, investigations. And while they're talking about different things a while ago, you saw some of the stats that Jeff just showed about the burglaries being down. I'm very passionate about that. I always have been. I believe that if you want to talk about self-defense and timing's in, if you want to talk about self-defense, you have to start with law enforcement being proactive in your community, stopping problems before they happen. When I first took over as major and captain as major in patrol division investigations when I ran that, I really targeted hard thefts. I wanted burglaries down. I wanted break-ins of cars down. And I'm proud to say in 3 years of that I was there as captain and then major of that division, I reduced the burglaries by 36% countywide. And I reduced car break-ins by 25% the first 2 years. So it is something we can do together. You may have mentioned a while ago, people in the neighborhood said, you know, I didn't call. We begged. I ran newspaper articles over and over and over through the community news, which is now Dawson News. We ran all kinds of things saying, please call us, tell us. We have situations that you wouldn't believe that people come out and see at 2 a.m. a group of kids walking down the road. This one particular guy saw at 2 a.m. this group of kids walking down the road, and he said, well, I thought they looked suspicious. I knew they were up to no good, but I didn't call anything. The next morning at 8 o'clock when he went out to get in his car to go to work, they'd stole stuff out of his car. Might have been a little poetic justice there. But we encourage these people to do this. We encourage people to call us, give us the tips, help us out. We work together. It's got to be a partnership with the community and the sheriff's office, and, you know, in the state patrol and everybody else that works here in Dawson County. So we work together to do those things. During my tenure, I know people talk about the Alamo. There was no smash and grabs during my time. Either captain or major in that situation, because we turned up the heat. We turned up the heat on these people in the places that we know that there are going to be problem spots at. And we make sure that we do that. We reduce crime. I was so passionate about burglaries. I remember talking to a friend of mine who works with us. We were going hunting together. We were going to Kentucky hunting. And he said, okay, it's been 2 years. We've reduced burglaries. When is it enough? And I said, as long as there's one too many. As long as there's two, there's an epidemic. I mean, in my opinion. And I tell you why. Some people don't see burglaries as important as others. It's just the truth. Some officers don't see burglaries as important as others. But for me, and we've had this situation almost happen once here in Dawson County, let's say that you have the person that's knocking on the door and trying to see if anybody's home and nobody answers. He goes into the house because he thinks no one's home, and you step out of the shower. Mm-hmm. Now, you just saw the guy that did this doing your burglary. He may not be so willing to let you go call the police. Mm-hmm. He may not be so willing to let you testify in court. Mm-hmm. So that simple burglary that some people say, well, they're just, you know, it's just a burglary, they stole stuff, is now turned into a murder, a rape. So it can escalate very, very fast. So that's the reason why there is no simple crimes. If you want to stop big crimes, you stop small crimes. That's the way to handle crime. In any community and anywhere else you go, you look at from New York City to Dawson County, Georgia. If you want to stop crime, you go after the little things, the broken windows theory. I've been tasked with doing self-defense. This is a kind of a tough situation. I told Heather outside, I'm not mad, but the average stat of teaching somebody one move in self-defense is it takes 10 hours to get that person trained well enough to use that you just taught them. So unless you want to go to, what time is it? You can, unless you've got breakfast coming in the morning, I'm going to make this quick tonight. We're just going to go over a few little things. They talked about it earlier. For me, though, the number one thing that we teach, I've taught kids in high school. We used to have a seniors class there that I love teaching those girls because they're getting to go to college. So I go in and teach those. I've taught self-defense for years to women in the community. I'll brag a little bit. One lady, I think she actually gave me a mild concussion. She's a teacher at one of the schools. I didn't feel too bad because she went home. Her husband said this stuff didn't work. She kicked him over the couch. So, I felt pretty good. That's another one. I thought I should have got a letter of accommodation from the husband saying, hey, I appreciate you teaching self-defense to my wife. It's kind of tough, like I said, to do this in a short amount of time. So the number one topic that you know that I want to talk about, and Frank hit on it just amazingly while ago, is the fact that you've got to pay attention. I mean, that's the number one thing. I'm married to the greatest woman in the world. I love her to death. She's the most amazing person. She grew up with a pastor's daughter. She's been all over the world. She sang in campus choirs and everywhere from L.A. stadiums to overseas. She's been all over the place. And we got married, my wife was the most trusting person, and she would go to the city of Atlanta and walk down through the neighborhoods and talk to everybody. I mean, I'm not that way. Obviously, in law enforcement, you get kind of jaded a little bit that you have to pay attention to your surroundings. And that's the number one thing, is to pay attention to your surroundings. Because usually you can find out, I did for a little bit, I don't believe that's a gut feeling. I'm a Christian, I believe God gives us opportunity to feel, see things that He wants us to see, that we don't get into those situations, that He helps us get that information to us. I believe that. Maybe I'm wrong, but I'll go to my grave with that. So I've had those same things. Other people have had those same things happen to them. I know everybody here that's been law enforcement has. So the number one thing is pay attention to what's around you, your surroundings. And the second thing that I teach every single time to these women is use your voice. That's what some people don't talk about enough. Use your voice. I don't know if you just saw this movie, but I love it. I love the movie that just came out. Lost the name, that's how it works, right? The what's the Christian movie those brothers made? It just come out. But no, not Heaven. The other one's just
The War Room.
War Room, thank you, War Room. Yeah. War Room. I love
recommended by Ted Cruz.
If you great movie. If you haven't saw it, you should see it. But War Room, there's a spot there where this guy's starting to rob these two women. And she basically says, I'm not giving you nothing. I plead the blood of Jesus over you. You ain't getting nothing. And, you know, obviously that's a decision you have to make. There's officers in that was acting, obviously. And they said, they could have hurt you. And he said, well, they could have. But, I mean, that's a decision you've got to make. I'm not saying don't give them your stuff. I think you got to do what's best for you to be safe. But in that situation, if you bark back, if you make sure they realize that you're not an easy target, most of the time they're going to seek somebody else. I'm telling you. Because the one thing that we know for sure, I mean, I think everybody can agree on this, is most criminals are lazy. So if you're not an easy target, you make it work. And if they wanted to work, they'd go get a job. So make it hard for them to do those kind of things. Make it really challenging. If you get confronted, they mention the little car alarms and different things, but make sure that you scream, that you yell, that you do everything that you can. And that's the biggest thing for me. I can show self-defense moves, but we'll be here all night, so I'm not going to do that. I am Tony Wooten. I'm running for sheriff at Dawson County. If you have any questions, I know she's giving me the 30 seconds.
How about a 3-pound weight in the purse?
Pretty I believe, and I teach this every time, I love guns, don't get me wrong, I'm a Second Amendment supporter, just like everybody else in this room.
Just a regular way.
Yeah, but you have to be, to me, to a certain degree, you have to be able to learn to use what you have been given by God. Because you're not going to always walk around with your gun on your holster. If that was not true, law enforcement wouldn't learn how to fight. So you've got to learn how to defend yourself to a certain degree. I'm not saying, I don't teach women to be like, how to just busted your nose, how to defend. I'm talking about to survive, to get away from the attack, to go somewhere else, to get help, to survive. Any questions other than that one? Yes, ma'am.
I've got a good one for you.
Yes,
my
ma'am.
Son lives in Florida, and this guy came up to him trying to sell him drugs. And my son, he puts his hand on him and says, Jesus loves you, brother. And the guy is to both brothers.
I mean, I'm a believer, so.
Yeah, I just really, you can only protect what you have. I mean, just try to make it harder for people to rob. Because we had somebody just ran him out on the road. They shot our friend to see the response time. The police will come, I think it was like maybe 5 minutes or something. And so, you know, we're all fenced in. We had an extra car. We're parked in front of it. Because you can't control what other people do. You can only protect what you have. So the harder you make it for them, the harder it is.
Use some common sense. I went to Miami one time, and I had to open my jacket at night to get them to buzz me in to get into the Pizza Hut. I didn't eat there. I mean, if it's that bad, and I got to get buzzed in, I'm going back to the hotel and walk in the room, put the rocks they talk about, get in the gun, lay it on the counter, get my key fob, and order take-in. Thank y'all. If y'all have any questions, I'll be here through the rest of this. Thank y'all for having me tonight. Thank y'all for supporting me.